Well, good evening. So we are discussing about, we are still in the third unit, is it? Third unit, and today's our topic is CSR. CSR terms are very popular. I think that's a household word today. All of us know what is CSR. Can anyone, if you elaborate, what is CSR?
Corporate social responsibility, sir.
Corporate social responsibility. That means what happens exactly. These corporates,
yes, sir,
are considered as social citizens, as a kind of citizens, corporate citizens. Okay, they got some kind of responsibility towards the society. And how that can be taken care of? You have to learn. And what are the legal requirements? That means what are the mandatory requirements that need to follow? Prior to this thing, prior to this kind of law, it was a kind of option. That means voluntarily some companies are adopting some kind of CSR mechanism. But now law has made it mandatory. That means mandatorily they have to do some kind of CSR activities. Right. So I am going to share with you the relevant screen right now. I think screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. It's visible, sir.
Well, friends, so our third unit in the syllabus contains all these things. Kinds of share capital voting rights, variation of shareholders' rights. We have covered all these things. Today, we'll be completing this aspect, corporate social responsibility, which is popularly called as CSR activity. Right. First, we'll understand what is the concept of CSR. So, as most of you must be knowing, it's a kind of management concept. And through this concept, attempts are made to integrate the social and environmental concerns with the business activities or with the business operations. And also, it ensures there should be proper interaction as regards to the CSR responsibility with the stakeholders. That means we need to communicate with this stakeholders. We need to communicate with the stakeholders that what kind of CSR activities the organization company is doing. Okay. So, it's, you can understand generally as a way through which company achieves the balance of economic, environmental and other social priorities or social importances. Okay. So, this concept is called as also triple bottom line approach. Some of you must be knowing it. That means we have to draw a balance between these three elements. One is people, second is planet, third one is profit. Okay, I think you are seeing this picture. We have to draw a balance through this CSR mechanism between people, planet and profit. Right? Okay? And while doing so, at the same time, we have to also address the expectations of the stakeholders, the expectation of the shareholders. What are the expectations of the stakeholders? Or what, let us say first discuss what is the expectation of the shareholders. Can
shareholders to increase the value, sir, the value of the organization.
Yeah, we shareholders want that share, that the value maximization, that the value should be maximized, right?
Yes.
Or you can say their wealth should be maximized, and that is possible if the value of shares can be increased, can be maximized.
Increase.
And like this, just like shareholders, there are other stakeholders are also there. Can you name some other stakeholders? Who are the other stakeholders?
Employees, suppliers.
Yes, employees, suppliers, government, bankers, credit,
government.
All these debtors, okay. All these things are stakeholders.
Financial institutions, sir.
Financial institutions, bankers, like that.
Banks, yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. So all we know, their expectations are different. Everybody expects a different thing. Just like shareholders want value maximization. Government wants something else. Society wants something else. Bankers want something else. Employees want something else. Right? Okay. So, the real responsibility of a manager is to ensure that all the stakeholders' interests are taken care of so that a sustainable growth can be achieved. Right? In long run, it will be possible to grow only when you will be satisfying all the stakeholders. That is the concept. Okay. So, if you want to achieve that and if you want to ensure that the corporate social responsibilities are taken care of, we have to broadly draw a balance between the planet, people, and the profit. That's the concept of CSR. Okay. Right. So, now we'll see what are the legal aspects to this. What are the provisions in the Companies Act 2013 as regards to CSR responsibility. Okay. And this section 135 deals with CSR responsibility. Section 135 of Companies Act 2013. If I read the subsection 1, you see it is read like this. Every company having net worth of 500 crore or more. So this is one criteria. If the company is having net worth of how much?
500 crore or more.
Or a turnover of rupees 1000 crore. Net worth, you have understood. Net worth, loosely speaking, it is the equity part. That means, let us say in the balance sheet, the total of the balance sheet consists, you can say, from the entire asset. If I reduce all the outsiders' liabilities, right, third party liabilities, whatever will remain, that will be considered as a net worth. That means that is the net worth of the equity shareholders of the company. If that equity part is 500 crore or more, then this provision is applicable. Or the turnover. Turnover means you can say the revenue part. Revenue means the sales or service income or any kind of miscellaneous income. All these things taken together is called as the turnover. If turnover is of rupees 1000 crore or more, or the net profit. Net profit you have already understood after charging all these expenses, whatever money is left, that is net profit. If the net profit is 5 crore or more. Right, any one of these conditions, if you are met, then this section becomes applicable. Okay, net worth 500 crore, turnover 1000 crore, and net profit 5 crore or more. Okay.
Sir, shall I ask a question, sir, here?
Yeah, please.
Sir, turnover, yeah. It is the net billing, sir, billing amount, or income and expenditure, both.
No, no. Turnover means only income. That is revenue part.
Revenue means it is a billing, sir. Whatever we do.
Yeah, billing. It is billing. It is billing. But if you are asking, it is net billing. Net billing means what do you mean by that? Are you talking about the net
excluding
of
GST?
No.
Including or excluding, sir?
It is including. Okay. Whenever you turnover, you have to take the gross turnover.
So including the excise, GST, everything?
Yeah.
Okay, gross turnover.
Right, so okay. Turnover means not the net value. When you talk about the bill amount means the gross amount, no?
Gross amount, total bill amount.
Right.
Okay, sir, I got it, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So net worth we have understood, turnover we have understood, and the net worth of 5 crore or the net profit of 5 crore or more during any financial year shall constitute a corporate social responsibility of the board. Shall constitute a corporate social responsibility committee of the board. That means if these conditions are met, a corporate social responsibility committee needs to be formed. The board of directors has to have a committee. The name of the committee will be corporate social responsibility of the board. Okay. Now, what will be the composition of the board? Three or more directors. At least three directors, there can be more directors. And one more condition, one of them should be at least one of them should be an independent director. So this is the first legal requirement. I think you have understood. Net yes, worth, sir. 500 crore or more. Turnover, rupees 1000 crore or more. Net profit, 5 crore or more. In any financial year, if any of these criteria is met, then CSR committee needs to be formed. And the members
so net profit is shown in the this one, sir. What do you call the assessment?
No. IT, assessments, you are talking about the income profit. Tax assessment.
Income tax assessment, yes, sir.
Income tax assessment, what you show, that is, you show the okay, income sir. From profit and gains of business and profession. Okay, that is not necessarily yes, the net profit. If you want to understand the okay. net profit, you can do one thing or some other case I will be showing. Please download annual sure. report of any company or maybe from your own company, you download it. Right, download okay, the sir. Annual report. You can find out inside that sir. Financial statement consisting of balance sheet, statement of profit and loss, cash flow statement, okay, explanatory notes, all these things will be there. And in that statement of profit and loss, you can find out net profit.
Sir.
Okay. And I will suggest you, please go through your own company's annual report. You can find all these things. You can find out the, in the board of directors report also, if you read, if you think everything which is required under this law must have been included there. At. Right. So corporate social responsibility committee needs to be framed. At least three directors and at least one of the directors should be independent. Okay. So this is what I'm showing in this form. Right. So annual turnover 1,000 crore, net worth 500 crore, net profit of 5 crore or more. Then there is a requirement. And other things I'll be teaching you subsequently. Okay. Then how much money has to be spent? That minimum 2%. Okay. And one more thing you have to see. These three conditions has to be seen during any of the three preceding financial years. You have to check these conditions for any of the three preceding financial years. So during any of the three preceding 5 years, if any of these conditions are met, then CSR provisions are applicable. Okay. And this much money has to be spent.
Sir, if, for example, in last 3 years, in middle 1 year, we achieved out of this one, anyone.
Yeah.
But out of these 2 years, we are not... Achieved.
Yeah, that doesn't matter. Any one of the 3 years.
Okay. So then we need to do this expenditure for that 1 year or all 3 years?
Then not for all years, but the current year. Suppose let us say we are talking about this financial year, let us say 2021.
Okay.
Sir. Okay. For 2021, we are planning how much money I have to spend. Then I have to see, first of all, whether this particular provision is applicable to me. Then I have to see the preceding three financial years. But 2021 is sir. There. So, okay.
Yes, sir.
Then I have to apply the
So, product. Then 16, 17, 17, 18, 18, 19. I have to see 3 years.
No, 3 years means 19, 20, 18, 19, 17, 18.
17, 18.
Okay. These are the 3 years you have to see.
Okay. Then I need to plan for this year, 2021.
Yeah, I have to plan for this year. Once I see the 3 years criteria, then I'll be able to know whether this provision is applicable to me or not. If it is applicable,
okay.
Then I have to spend the 2%. The 2% part I'll be covering subsequently. But right now we're discussing about the application. Now, subsection 2 talks about the board report. Board report means the board of directors report. Shall disclose the composition of the CSR committee. Right. So company must form a CSR committee. Okay. If CSR committee is formed, the board of directors report must disclose all these things. That what is the composition of the CSR committee. Right. And the CSR committee shall, this particular part talks about the responsibility of the CSR committee. Shall formulate and recommend to the board corporate social responsibility policy. Which shall indicate the activities to be undertaken by the company as specified in Schedule 7. That means, coming to the responsibility of the CSR committee, the CSR committee shall formulate and recommend the corporate social responsibility policy. That means, here is a requirement to frame a CSR policy. That has to be framed. Okay. And the company should indicate what are the activities that it is going to undertake. Okay, and all these activities cannot be considered as CSR activities. There is a list of activities which are mentioned in Schedule 7. I will be covering towards the last part of the class. I will be covering what are the activities which are included in Schedule 7. So, only those activities can be considered as CSR activities. Right. So, policy needs to be framed. Then, recommend the amount of expenditure to be incurred for this activity. How much expenditure needs to be incurred? Okay, that 2% part just I showed you, I was supposed to show you subsequently. But first of all, 2% is the minimum requirement. But CSR committee can decide. If they plan, it can spend more also. And also one more responsibility is to monitor the corporate social responsibility policy of the company. So first of all, formulate the policy and decide what are the activities to be undertaken. then recommend the expenditure to be income and monitor the implementation of this CSR policy. Okay, right. At this stage, if you recapitulate, we have learned that three or more directors, one of the directors should be independent director, that should constitute the CSR committee. This committee shall formulate and recommend the CSR policy. Right. And the areas, the working area, or you can say activities which are to be considered as CSR activities are already listed in Schedule 7 of the Companies Act 2013. We will be seeing that activities. Committee shall also recommend the activities and the amount of expenditure that is to be incurred. Committee shall also monitor the CSR policies. Okay. Now, that is the CSR committee's responsibility. Now coming to the board's responsibility. The board of director has the following responsibility. Now, you know, CSR committee has recommended. Now, after taking into account the recommendations made by the CSR committee, approve the CSR policy. CSR policy has to be approved by the board of directors and disclose the content of this policy in its report and also place in the company's website. That means what is the content of the CSR policy must be disclosed in the board report, must be disclosed in the director's report as well as in the company's website. Right. In addition to that, board should also ensure that the activities included in the CSR policy are undertaken. The company should undertake that policy. Board need to ensure that. Okay. Now coming to the quantum, that how much money is to be spent. Right. First, what we have learned, let me go back. If this, any one of these three conditions are met, right, then company needs to form a CSR committee. Right. Now coming to how much money has to spend. Money has to spend 2%. How it is to be calculated? We have to see the preceding 3 years financial statement that is coming under this particular provision. Now you see, the board of director of every company referred to in section 1 shall ensure that the company spends in every financial year at least 2% of the average net profit of the company made during the three immediately preceding financial years. That means what we have to see? We have to calculate what is the average net profit of the preceding three financial years and how much company has to spend? At least 2% of the average net profit. Okay. That means in the current year, suppose for 2021, I am planning to incur some expenditure. I have to take the average profit of the past 3 years. That is 1920, 1819, and 1718. Okay. And I will be arriving at what is the 2% of that, and minimum that money has to be spent in the year 2021. I think it is clear now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the amount has to be arrived at on the basis of previous three financial years average net profit. Okay. And there is one more requirement, that company has to give preference to the local area or the area around which the company operates. So CSR activities, to the extent possible, should be centered around local areas and the areas of operation of the company. That is one more requirement. And one more requirement is that if the board fails to do so, if the board is unable to spend the 2% of the previous 3 years average profit, then board is expected to specify the reasons for not spending the amount. In the board report, they should clearly state that why they have not been able to spend that much of money. Okay. Now, how this average net profits will be computed, that is explained in this another section, that is section 198. 198 talks about how we will be computing net profit of different 3 years and then we will be averaging it out. Okay. Now, if you recapitulate at this stage, the role of the board is to form a CSR committee, to approve CSR policy, to disclose the content of the board report and place it on the company's website, ensure implementation of the CSR activities, shall ensure that the company spends in every financial year at least 2% of the average net profit of the company made during the three immediately preceding financial years. Right. But however, if the company has not completed the period of three financial years since it is incorporation, that means if it is a new company, then during such immediately preceding financial years, suppose the company is only 2 years old, then 2 years, two financial years, preceding financial years has to be taken into account. And one more requirement is that disclose the reasons for not spending the amounts. Okay, if the amount for some reason has not been spent, that needs to be disclosed. Now, how to calculate that net profit? In computing the net profit, under section 198, we have to refer to certain procedures you have to follow. It says the credit has to be given for the sum specified in the subsection 2. We'll see there is a list of items in the subsection 2. Then credit shall be given. Credit shall be given means that those things will be considered as the income. Right? And credit shall not be given for those which are specified in subsection 3. That means subsection 3, there will be again list of the item which will not be considered as income. Then sum specified in the subsection 4 shall be deducted. And sum specified, the item specified in subsection 5 shall not be deducted. Shall be deducted means they will be considered as an expenditure. Not deducted means they will not be considered as an expenditure. This is how profits can be arrived at. Right? So some items will be considered as income. Some items will not be considered as income. Some items will be considered as expenditure. Some items will not be considered as expenditure. Okay? So there are four subsections, one by one we have to cover. First, credit shall be given. Subsection 2 contains the items to which credit shall be given. That means they will be considered as income. What are these items? Credit shall be given to the bounties, subsidies received from the government or public authority. If some kind of award, reward, subsidies, etc. will be given, that will be considered as income. Therefore, credit shall be given. Okay. Considering that thing as income, profits will be computed. Then credit shall not be given. These are the items for which credit shall not be given. That means it should not be considered as income. What are these things? Profits by way of premium for sale of shares or debentures. If the company sells shares and debentures, that profit will not be considered. Profit and sale of forfeited shares. If the shares are forfeited, that profit will not be considered as income. Profits of capital nature. If some capital asset is sold, not the company's normal revenue assets. Okay, not inventories. If some capital asset is sold, that profit is will not be considered as income. Profit for sale of immovable property or fixed assets, those profits will also not be taken into account. Right? Or any change in the carrying amount of the assets, that means because of some revaluation, if some income has been generated, that will not be considered. Okay, these items will not be considered as income. Now coming to sums that will be deducted. That means these items will be considered as expenditures. Number one is usual working charges. Okay. Director's remuneration, bonus commission, taxes notified by the central government, or any other taxes imposed by special for some special regions or from some kind of special circumstances. If the central government imposes some extra tax, that will be also deducted as an expenditure. Interest on debentures, that is also an expenditure. Interest on mortgages executed by the company. So all these kind of items will be considered as the expenditure. These things should be deducted. There are some more other items are also there. Interest on unsecured loan, expenses on repairs, depreciation. Okay, so many items are there. We need not remember it one by one. But we should have some idea that these are the expenditures which shall be deducted. Compensation or damages. Some paid by way of insurance. Debt considered, that means bad debts or debts written off. Insurance charges, all these items are deducted. They will be considered as expenditure. Okay. Now subsection 5 talks about the items which are not considered as expenditure. That means these are the sums which are not going to be deducted to arrive at the average profit. What are these items? Income tax will not be deducted. Compensation, damages for payments or any kind of voluntary compensation given, those expenditures will not be deducted. Losses of capital nature or any kind of losses due to revaluation of the assets. If the, there is any changes in the carrying amount of the asset, that means if you are revaluating the asset, those assets will not, those revaluation losses will not be considered as expenditure. These sums will not be deducted from the revenue to arrive at the average profit. Okay, so we have learned section, subsection 2, 3, 4, 5. Subsection 2, I repeat, talks about the credit shall be taken. That means these items will be considered as income. Subsection 3 talks about credit shall not be taken. That means these will be considered, this will not be considered as an income. Subsection 4 talks about sums shall be deducted. That means these are the expenditure. Subsection 5 talks about sums shall not be deducted. That means these are not the expenditures. Okay. Now, after understanding this, how to arrive at the average profit. So once we know the average profit of the previous 3 years, we'll be able to compute the minimum amount required to be spent. That is 2% of that. 2% needs to be spent. And here we have to keep one thing in the mind. It is also possible to do the CSR projects through collaboration. That means one company can join hand with the other company. And through this collaboration, they can also do CSR activities. But that is possible, provided the CSR committees of the respective companies are in a position to report separately on such projects or programs in accordance with their rules. So they can do the activities jointly, but they should be able to report it separately. So each company should be able to report that how much money he has spent and the detail of the CSR activities. That is the requirement. And how report has to be made? This is a template. In this template, reporting has to be made. That is serial number, how much project wise you have to use serial number. CSR project and activities identified. We have to refer it to the Schedule 7 of the Companies Act, which are the activities. Sector in which project is covered. What is the program? What is the amount of outlay? What is the amount spent? What is the cumulative amount spent? And amount spent directly or through some implementing agency. This, all these things need to be reported in the board report. Okay. Now, as we are talking about, that all these activity or any activity will not be considered as CSR activities. We have to see the activities which are included in the Schedule 7 of the Companies Act. And Schedule 7 of the
Companies Act. One doubt, sir.
Yeah, please ask.
One doubt.
Yeah, please.
Sir, suppose the company doesn't have any net profit. Suppose the company is running on losses.
Yeah.
So shall there be any CSR, sir?
Losses in the previous 3 years?
Yes, sir.
No need. No need. Okay. Right. If there is losses, there is no profit, then there is no need to spend money on CSR activities.
But voluntarily, 2% on profit. So if there is no profit, there is no question, sir.
Yeah, there is
no. It is a 2% spend on profit.
Yeah. There is a question.
Yeah, 2% spend. There is no profit, the 2% will come zero.
Yeah, that's you are right. No, no. But still, since you have raised that question, let me tell you, this confusion is there in many people's mind. Let me make it very clear. So, as you are right, so since there is no profit, no money has to be spent, there is no requirement. Is it not? And law requires, law requires that if for some reason you are unable to spend the mandatory amount which is required, then you have to, boards has to give a disclosure. Right. So, practically, we have seen many companies when there is no requirement, that means loss is there, and because of that, they have not spend that money, but they are giving disclosure. Now, question is it required to give disclosure in that kind of situation?
Not required.
Not required. You are right. But if you read many companies' financial statement, you can find disclosure is there. And to that, if you read the CAG report, that is Controller and Auditor General's report, many times CAG had objected. This is not required, why you are disclosing?
Sir.
Okay. Okay. But this that means this confusion is there not only in your mind, in many companies, board are also in doubt that whether you should disclose it or not to disclose, whether it is required or not required. Okay. But CAG has objected to some of these cases. Right. A good thing that you asked so that, okay, we could discuss all these things. Now, just wait a minute. Let me share that file once again.
There are 6 minutes left, sir, time.
Yeah, we'll be able to complete it within that.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, so I was showing you that these are the, you see, list of the items which are included in the Schedule 7. So only these activities will be considered as the CSR activities. Like some activities that will lead to eradicating extreme hunger or poverty, promotion of education, promoting gender equality, reducing child mortality, improving maternal health, okay, combating this thing, this AIDS and some related diseases, malaria, etc. Okay, HIV, all this, combating all these kind of diseases, environmental sustainability, enhancing vocational skills, social businesses, Prime Minister's National Relief Fund, and now only yesterday, this item has been added through notification that Prime Minister Citizen Artisan Assistance and Relief in Emergency Situation of Fund or PM CARES Fund. This fund has been also added yesterday only in the Schedule 7. Okay, rural development projects, slum area development, disaster management, all these things, including relief, rehabilitation, construction activities. These activities will be considered as the CSR.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, now this COVID time, last month, so many corporate companies has given the checks to the PM Relief Fund.
Yes.
So that amount also you will come under social responsibility, sir?
Yeah, they are under CSR.
Okay. For this COVID relief.
PM Relief Fund as well as PM CARE, both the things are included.
Both
are included.
Thank you, sir.
Some activities are not falling under CSR activities. First of all, if it is for the benefit of your own employees, for the company's own benefit, you are doing some kind of activities, that is not CSR activities. Okay. And let us say some kind of marathons, awards, charitable contributions, advertisements, sponsorship, the TV programs, these are not CSR activities. Activities not taken as a project, they are also not CSR activities. Okay, expenditures incurred to fulfill some statutory obligation. If there is some legal obligation to meet that thing, you are incurring some activities, that is not CSR activities. Right. And contribution made directly or indirectly to political party, that is also not CSR activities. Activities undertaken by the company in pursuance of the normal course of the business. Under normal course of the business, if some activities are undertaken, that they are also not CSR activities. So what are CSR activities? It has been very clearly mentioned in the Schedule 7. This is the implementation process, how the company step by step conducts the CSR activities. You can go through this. First, develop a CSR strategy. Then decide how it can be implemented, identify the team and builds its capacity to implement that thing. Then involve some implementing agencies so that these projects can be carried on. Then project development detailed project report is prepared. Okay. Then what is the CSR budget? The amount is budgeted. Project's approval is made. Then agreement is finalized with implementing agents. Then project is implemented. Project is documented. Then project is evaluated. Project impact assessment is made. What is the impact of the project? That assessment is also made. Then finally, the reports are made in the desired format, which I had shown. In that format, the reports are published. These are the various steps. You can go through this. Okay. And this is an example. You see how the company is disclosing in the CSR activities. As you know, it has to disclose in the board report as well as the website. If you go to the website of this company, you see CSR under this, about CSR, flagship of CSR projects, other CSR projects, CSR expenditure report, CSR assessment, media feedback, all these things under the CSR, all these things company reports. You can try in any company's website, you can find out any big company's website. When this criteria is met, you can understand what are the how the company is undertaking CSR activities. Okay, so this was broadly about the statutory requirement for CSR activities which are covered under Companies Act 2013. Alright, so quickly if we once again summarize, we'll go back to that slide, previous slide. This one. So this particular slide talks about the eligibility or you can say the conditions. If this any of these conditions are complied by the company, then CSR committee needs to be formed. Right. And once there is a requirement, that committee is formed, money has to be spent, that how that will be computed. We have to compute minimum 2% of the average net profit of the previous 3 years.
Okay. Sir, one doubt, sir. Who, under section 198, sir, who will calculate the net profit, sir, after deducting
company
all the
has to calculate. Company has to calculate in accordance with the section 198. If the company who has to calculate.
And the profit section also, profit and part also, it will be coming under the disclosure, sir. Disclosure head.
Yeah, yeah. How much is the profit? How much company has spent? All these disclosures should be made. Very simple process. Sir. So practically,
can you make the slides, sir?
Yeah, if you see a company's report, you will be able to easily understand. But for our purpose, this much is sufficient. Just we need to understand